According to NASA, Saturn, the big ringed planet, is losing its rings at a quote, worst case scenario rate. This is because Saturn's rings are being pulled into the planet by gravity and they are raining down as dusty ice particles under the influence of Saturn's magnetic field. Saturn without rings? Is anybody else super upset about this? I feel like Saturn's going through an identity crisis. What is happening? This is InformOverload. I'm Charlotte Dobre and on this channel we talk about what's trending on the internet. So basically, if you're new here, we find the coolest, most interesting news stories on the web and we tell you about them so you can sound super cool and informed to your friends. If that sounds something you're into, like, sub, and turn on those notifications. Then follow the IO team on social media. Our links are posted down below in the description. It's been a while since we talked about space on this channel. I missed it. Everybody likes space, right? Right? Cool. Glad we can agree on something. Let me know what your favorite planet is down there in those comments, but while you ponder that, I'm gonna fill you in on what's happening to our beloved Saturn. Saturn is a planet that's 4 billion years old. It's the 6th planet from the sun, the 2nd largest in our system, and a gas planet. Its year is 29.4 Earth years, but it's best known for its iconic rings that dress the planet and make it look like it's sporting a hula hoop. So a Saturn without rings. That is honestly really difficult to imagine, but according to NASA scientists, the process has already begun. Saturn's rings look like rings to us, but up close, they are made up of billions of chunks of water ice, ranging in size from microscopic dust grains to boulders that are several meters across. These chunks hang in the balance of being pulled into Saturn by gravity and being flung back outward into space by their orbital velocity. The rings stretch 175,000 miles across. Scientists don't know if Saturn's rings formed later or if they formed with the formation of the planet. If they were formed later, it's possible that the rings are actually fragments that used to be icy moons that were broken apart by gravitational forces from a passing asteroid or comet. But according to new research, Saturn's rings are not that old. They have only been orbiting the planet for around 100 million years, which is right around the time when dinosaurs roamed our planet. And right now, the rings of Saturn are raining down on the planet at an alarming rate. The quote, maximum rate, as estimated from Voyager 1 and 2 observations that were made decades ago. According to James O'Donohue of NASA's Goddard Space Flight Center, we estimate that this ring rain drains an amount of water products that could fill an Olympic-sized swimming pool from Saturn's rings in half an hour. That's 22,000 pounds per second that's falling on the equator of Saturn. Once the particles are in the upper atmosphere, they vaporize and the water reacts with Saturn's ionosphere. And then when they are energized by sunlight, the ions glow in infrared light. That's how scientists figured out that Saturn's rings are raining down on Saturn. It was previously thought that it would take Saturn 300 million years to shed its rings, but that number seems to be wrong. According to new data, in less than 100 million years, Saturn's rings might be gone completely. So like, it's not like Saturn's just gonna wake up one day and be naked and be like, ah! 100 million years might sound like a pretty long time, but when you think about how old Saturn is, which is 4 billion years, it's not actually that long. So this actually gives us new insight into the science of ringed planets. Saturn losing its rings means that rings might actually be only temporary, which means that Jupiter, Uranus, and Neptune might have had huge rings in the past. They only have thin ringlets now. But truthfully, I'm still bummed about Saturn losing its rings. Without them, it's just gonna be like this boring beige planet. It's gonna be just naked out there in space. I feel bad for it. Anyways, friends, that is all I have for you on that. Let me know your thoughts in the comments down below, but for now, I'm gonna do some comment replies. Abby Cobb said, there is nothing funny about IO. Eats invisible potato. Nothing at all. Ooh, that feeling when you're about to be featured in the comments. I wanna see the dance, Charlotte. No! Bambrick Vlog said, Potato Queen is my dad. Yes. Gama said, hey Charlotte, remember that prophecy about the world ending back in April? Good memories. Yes, I remember, and I'm sorry, is the world like not over? I guess it depends on who you're talking to. Nia Streeter said, hey Charlotte, at my school we were doing a kindness project. You pick a name from a bowl and do something nice for that person. The project is about spreading kindness. Maybe people could learn something from us. I feel like that should be a requirement for all schools. Crossy Gamer said, I love the videos. Keep up the work. Enjoy Christmas and the new year, both you and the team. Thank you very much. Have a great Christmas and new year as well. Just wanted to take the opportunity to let you guys know that I'm gonna be away next week because I'm seeing my family. So Johnny's gonna be covering for me. So be nice. Welcome to the end screen. This means the video is over. If you wanna keep watching IO, check out this playlist over here. It's probably got a bunch of videos just like this one, so you might like it. And obviously, if you enjoyed your time here, smash that like, subscribe, and notification bell, and I will see you in the next IO video.